Hello sellers! Magandang umaga, magandang tanghali, or magandang gabi po sa inyong lahat. Depending on anong oras po ninyo pinapanood ang ating episode 2. Yes, tama po. We are having our second episode of the Seller Incubation Mobcast. Nakakatawa. So kung hindi nyo pa po napapanood yung first episode, nasa YouTube lang po yan. It's uploaded in our official Shopee University YouTube page. Hanapin nyo lang po yung ating episode 1. That's basically a Seller Incubation Journey. Marami po kayong matututunan din sa guest natin ng nakaraang episode. But today is going to be extra special because meron na naman po tayong special guest na mag-share ng kanyang learning, experience, lahat ng pinagdaanan niya about penalty points. Okay? So kung meron po kayong gustong matutunan, meron kayong gustong malaman about seller penalty points, then please continue watching hanggang matapos ang ating episode for today. So hindi ko na po papatagalin pa. I'm so excited to introduce our guest for today. No other than Ma'am Sheena, Miss Sheena from 21 Stop Shop. Let's all welcome Ma'am Sheena. Wow, ang fresh,
hi,
fresh
po
naman.
Hey,
ang fresh naman ni Ma'am Sheena. Okay
medyo
lang ba yan,
ma'am?
Pero okay, yes, naman.
Po,
okay naman. Okay naman. Gusto mo maminom ka muna ng tubig. Okay lang yan. Huwag kang ma-pressure.
Ayos.
Ayaw po. Ma'am, okay. Sige, I'll give you a chance naman to introduce yourself and give us a little information. Background naman po ng inyong shop info ninyo, ng store ninyo, para makilala kayo ng ating mga NQ sellers din na nanonood sa atin.
Yes, well, hi everyone. Again, I'm Sheena. I'm one of the owners of 21 Stop Shop in Shopee. So, me and my partner actually started our shop last year. That was June of 2020. So, that was during the pandemic. We actually started that because we actually resigned from our corporate jobs nung January because we were supposed to work abroad nung March. Pero inabot kami ng lockdown ng mga international flights. So, blessing in disguise din siya since hindi kami natuloy. That's when we decided na, well, since we already resigned na, why not try e-commerce? So, eto, andito na kami ngayon.
So, almost 1 year na po o lagpas na? Lagpas na, no? September or almost na?
Opo, nag-1 year anniversary na po kami. Our shop, basically, ang specialties namin ay customized LED lamps, home decorations, home and kitchen essentials and appliances.
Wow, that's so nice. And Ma'am Sheena, you started actually during the peak of the pandemic. No. Saka yes. Kayo nag-start na din yung selling journey. Nakaka-impress, nakakatuwa naman. So how is it right now, no, after for having to manage your shop for more than a year? How can you explain your experience? How would you explain it to sa mga co-sellers?
When we actually started, parang sumabay lang talaga kami sa trend because our first products were the KN95 masks. So we started from there, and then nung medyo natapos na yung trend niya, we looked for other products na, because we, actually wala kaming background sa business ng partner ko, as in totally wala, because both of us came from corporate. So parang the basic things like products that are eye-catching, na affordable, na alam mo yun, na madaling bilhin. Kung gusto mong magbigay ng regalo, yun yung isa sa mga mako-consider mo. So, that's when we started yung lamps. So, nung naging okay naman na siya, then we were invited to be part of the incubation program. We joined nung last March, and then we just graduated from incubation last May 4. So that was 2 months. So during incubation program, doon na mas nag-boost yung shop namin because na-introduce sa amin yung mga techniques na naturo sa amin ni ano. Can I say the name of ano para ma-shoutout ko na din?
Oh, of course po.
Ay, si Sir Gao yung naging incubation manager ko. Hi, Sir Gao. Kumusta? Ayun po. He taught us a lot. Like, for example, yung pag... just to share, yung products namin for the lamps, we have 200 plus designs. Sa lamps pa lang yun. So, imagine the time that it consumes us just for us to update yung stocks and inventory. So, nung pumasok na kami sa incubation program, naturuan kami ni Sir Gao how to manage our time in terms of helping us sa pag-inventory. So, naturuan niya kami yung sa Excel, tsaka yung pag-update ng stocks, yung mass update in terms of stocks, tsaka yung sa discounts. Ayun, tapos siya na rin yung nag-asikaso sa amin in terms of flash deals, yung creative pricing na tinatawag wherein yung mga SRP ay, you know, we will give discounts for that. Yung mga ganung thesis. So, ayun, yun yung mga naging learnings namin during incubation program. So, after that, when we graduated, na-apply pa rin namin sila until now. So, there, yun po yung naging learnings namin.
Nakakatuwa naman ma'am. Well, congratulations kasi now you're obviously one of our managed sellers already because you were able to graduate from the incubation. So sabihin lang noon, you were able to perform really well during the incubation phase. Diba? Kaya po nakagraduate tayo from incubation. And kayo na rin naman po yung nag-mention that was because of the help given and the assistance na rin given to you by Gao from the incubation team.
Yes, yes.
Yan. Okay, so ma'am, I'm just curious, no? Because I'm sure you did well, you know, during the time that you were still part of the incubation. Can you still remember if was there an instance na nagkaroon kayo ng penalty? Or you had to be punished, no? Or punished with a penalty. Na nagkaroon ba kayo ng ganun ng situation? During the incubation phase
niyo? During incubation phase, fortunately none, but prior to that, nung wala pa kami sa incubation program, we only did once, and that was branding sa products. Parang it was misleading branding because before, we were partnered with this chips. It's about chips, sa food siya. So, pinasok din namin yun. Pinasok namin sa 21 Stop Shop. And parang nagka-problem lang sa branding. So Shopee is requiring na if may talagang brand talaga yung chips na yon, there should be a brand stated sa packaging. Wherein yung sa amin, pag galing kasi sa manufacturing, wala silang nilalagay na brand. So, tendency is, ang dami na naming sold dun sa ano, dun sa product na yon. And then kapag mag-update kami ng stocks, nadidelete siya ni Shopee. That was the one instance. But during incubation program, fortunately, wala na kaming naging ganong issue. So, yun lang. Yun lang yung time na
yun. Yun lang. Well, magaling talaga. Magaling talaga yung performance mo kasi hindi kayo nagkaroon ng penalty. Pero sige ma'am, tulungan natin yung mga currently still, you know, part of the incubation na mas maintindihan pa nila yung penalty ko. Sige. Ma'am, Q&A tayo, mama. Let's have like a quick game about seller penalty points. So, sige. Kasi I know na since you have never incurred a penalty, so I would assume that you're very familiar with the policy, like the guidelines, so what to do and what not to do para we remain good at having, you know, operations performance. Yeah? So, sige ma'am, ilang percent, first question ko to sa inyo, ano ang threshold ng NFR bago magkaroon ng penalty po?
Threshold for NFR, I'm not really good in terms of technical terms. I'll guess siguro 6%.
6%? Yeah. Well, okay lang yun na. Walang problema. Kasi you were performing well naman. Kaya hindi talaga kayo siguro masyadong naging exposed, no? Sa policy ng seller penalty. Pero ang threshold po natin ay 15%. Okay, that's for NFR at saka NSR. So if you go beyond the 15% threshold, that's when you'll start to enter penalty points.
Okay.
So, sana naman po, how many points will a seller get if he or she is caught asking a customer to cancel an order?
Oh, I'm gonna guess again. I'd say 2 points.
Wow, congratulations. That's the correct answer. 2 points to yan. 2 points if napatunayan, di ba, after investigation, mapatunayan na the seller or yung shop, you know, asked the customer to cancel an order. Okay, ma'am, usually, ano yung mga dahilan ng NFR? Bakit hindi na, sa question number 3 na, this is going to be my last question. If, for example, go beyond 15% threshold, ang mga reasons po, no, ng pag-exceed ng threshold is canceling the order. It's either, you know, the seller initiated the cancellation, kayo. Bakit po madalas nagka-cancel si seller? Kasi, di ba, walang stocks. Diba? Hindi ko alam, ma'am, Sheena, kung na-experience yun na you had to cancel an order dahil wala pala kayong stocks. Did you ever experience that?
Yes, of course. I experienced that because yung na-share ko earlier, since we have like so many designs, it's hard to keep track of every design if they're in stock or not. So, minsan magugulat kami na may papasok na orders and then kapag chinek namin yung shelves namin, ay, okay, wala tayong stock. And then, whenever we replenish, sometimes it takes weeks para makuha ulit yung stock na yun. So, no choice. We have to cancel. Or sometimes we talk to the buyer first if they would like to exchange it for another design. But if yun talaga yung gusto ng design and there's really nothing much we could do, we would need to cancel.
So, given that situation, Ma'am Sheena, ano yung parang pinaka-learning ninyo from that experience? Na pagtingin niyo sa warehouse, oh my God, we don't have the stocks of the item. So, syempre, surprising yun at some point sa inyo, di ba? And at the same time, it's a situation that you wouldn't want to happen again kasi it would maybe cause customer dissatisfaction, di ba? So, ano po yung ginawa niyo action? When you experience that na you got surprised with the order volume and then when you check your inventory, wala pala kayo ng design na yun, ano yung unang pumasok sa isip natin to rectify that issue?
First, I'd say when we started having that issue, time management first, we allotted a specific time to check designs and make sure na, you know, just really browse through if they're in stock. Second, nung medyo bumibigat na yung orders, since nakapag-forecast naman kami na maganda naman yung papasok na income, kumuha kami ng machine, a machine para kami na mismo yung gumagawa ng designs. Para kung mawalan man ng stock, we have a backup machine so that kami na mismo yung gumagawa. Kami, kumbaga parang yung raw materials sa amin na magagaling instead of us ordering sa suppliers na it takes days or weeks.
That's a very smart move. That's a very smart move, ma'am. Kayo na yung magpo-produce ng material para hindi na kayo mag-worry kung darating ba on time yung order ninyo from your supplier.
Okay.
And then last po, ano pa yung isa ninyo? Kasi ang ganda nung mga naging action plans yung action items ninyo.
Ayun po, yun ang... Sorry. Wait.
Okay lang po yan.
Yung nga, isa din sa mga yung nabanggit ko earlier, yung learnings ko with Sir Gao, making sure that yung Excel namin is updated for a specific time. Most of the time sa gabi kami nag-update ng accurate stocks sa... Ayun, every night. Para maiwasan namin yung...
Did you ever
try to
use ng virtual stocks? Nag-virtual stocks po ba tayo, Ember? Yung fake na stocks, pero hindi yun yung totoong volume. Nag-gumawa ba kayo ng ganun, Ember?
Meron. Kasi, you know, kapag very, may times na overwhelming, there are times na overwhelming talaga yung, pag minsan, pag busy ka na for the day, and then, you know, there's so much to do. So, minsan, virtual na lang. So, minsan, napaparami yung lagay, kahit in reality, konti na lang pala. So, ganun. Kaya nagkakaroon ng kaya tumataas yung NFR because of that.
So, is that something that you would suggest po? I mean, recommend sa mga co-sellers niyo to do, or something na you wouldn't want to ever recommend na gawin din nila? Yung virtual stock.
No, I don't recommend virtual stocks. It's a don't. Kasi yun nga. Opo. Kasi mahihirapan kay, parang yung sellers din kasi yung mahihirapan mag-explain kay buyers. What if maraming order? So you have to chat each and everyone. Ang pangit kasi if we're just gonna cancel out of nowhere, of course you have to explain first and then cancel if needed.
Okay, so mga sellers po na nanonood sa amin ngayon, ha, learn from Ma'am Sheena. She wouldn't recommend that you do virtual stocks. Okay, kayo po ang mahihirapan. And she's telling us all these from her own experience. Okay, so Ma'am Sheena, so you did well. So penalty, wala kayo naging penalty point. It happened only, I think, once, no? And you learned from it, yun sa virtual stock. You also parang come up with your own strategy na hindi na kayo kailangan mag-worry pa whether darating on time or late yung inyong order from supplier. So these are really very good and smart decisions para ma-prevent natin yung pagkakaroon ng problems, especially pag i-enter ng penalty. So, Ma'am Sheena, last po na, no, na advice ninyo sa mga sellers natin who are still part of the NQ and those who are feeling a little demotivated or still wondering if they're going to also graduate, if they're going to make it happen, yung mga aspirations nila while being part of the NQ program. Ano po yung words of wisdom or encouragement na pwede ninyong isi-share sa kanila ngayon? Yung galing mismo sa kung ano yung natutunan ninyo from your own experience.
I would really say to my co-sellers who are starting or who are part of the incubation program, I'd say na walang imposible, because for us, wala kaming business background. We never sold anything prior to the pandemic. And I would say na introverts kami. Hindi kami nagla-live kasi, you know, we're introverts.
Low-key.
So, at least there is Shopee na, you know, Shopee is giving us a voice para to really maximize yung e-commerce platform. But ayun, wag mawala ng pag-asa. Nothing is impossible talaga. Maximize trainings, yun din yung masasuggest ko. Maximize trainings, especially dito sa Shopee. There's a lot of free trainings kay Shopee. Kasi at least, and also do a lot of research as well for the do's and don'ts, because mahirap pasukin ang isang platform kapag pag salpak lang kayo na salpak ng products without knowing the process, just like what happened to us nung nagka penalty points kami before. It was because lagay lang kami ng lagay ng product without reading anything, kasi we thought yung Shopee okay lang yan kahit anong ilagay. So hindi pala. So really maximize yung trainings. Kapag may free training, normally makikita siya sa mga pop-up sa apps. Kapag may mga free seller trainings, i-grab nyo yun lagi, attend lagi. Sobrang helpful nun. And yung mga incubation manager nyo, very thankful kay Sir Gao, kasi minsan kahit, alam kong out na niya, pero he would really look into my issue. And talagang tutulungan kayo. Because there are times na we've encountered problems instead of us reaching out sa Shopee customer service, because there are times talaga na may high chat volume or high call volume. At least with our incubation managers there, isang chat away lang sila and matutulungan talaga nila kayo. At least you will really feel prioritized by Shopee. So yun, wag mawala ng pag-asa. We also had people telling us na hindi okay yung mga products namin. I mean, hindi siya pang long term, but don't listen kasi dito sa Shopee, like, sobrang laki ng support na makukuha nyo. Trainings pa lang, like, kumpleto na. Tsaka yung help center, always read through help center. Ayun po.
Okay. So, mga sellers, three important points po yan ang iwan sa atin ni Ma'am Sheena ngayon. Number one, huwag mo mawala ng pag-asa. Number two, utilize and take advantage of free training courses that are being offered. And lastly, tulad nga po ng binanggit ni Ma'am Sheena kanina, build a good relationship with your account manager or your incubation manager. Ma'am Sheena, nako, definitely maraming natutunan at na-inspire ang kwento ninyo, no? Sa mga current NQ sellers natin ngayon, especially yung mga kayo, bagong-bago pa lang.
Oh, yes.
Started just last year, the peak of the pandemic, and right now, wala na sila sa incubation. They're already part of our VIPs or the managed accounts again. And then so, lahat po ng tips and yung mga experiences that Ma'am Sheena has shared with all of us, sana po may natutunan kayo doon at gawin po ninyong inspiration at motivation para mag-strive harder pa at maging positive in thinking na you're definitely all gonna graduate from the NQ, and just like what Ma'am Sheena has experienced, we're also going to be successful Shopee sellers. So Ma'am Sheena, maraming salamat po for your time. I appreciate it. Thank you for yung gracing our invitation and, you know, for accommodating us dito sa ating second episode. You're officially one of our seller ambassadors. Ayan, so kung meron po kayong gustong matutunan at kung meron kayong gustong malaman ng mga strategies or ideas, or if you want to get inspired na din, pwede nyo pong i-visit yung store ni Ma'am Sheena na 21 Stop Shop. Okay, be inspired kung how is she designing her store, her shop, kung paano siya nagkaroon ng magandang rating, chat response, at yung mga likes and followers niya, pwedeng-pwede niyo pong bisitahin ang 21 Stop Shop. So, magandang gabi po. Kami, para sa iyo to, Ma'am Sheena. Thank you again. Thank you very much to you, our seller ambassador. And to all of you watching, maraming salamat po. I hope you learned a lot from our episode today, and please support Shopee University's official YouTube page, and stay tuned po for episode 3 ng ating Incubation Seller Mobcast. Ma'am Sheena, thank you very much, and to all of you, our sellers, thank you for watching. See you all very soon. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you. Bye-bye.